The Quick 220 uses two standard 110 outlets. In a residential application, we use a kitchen plug, and then we will plug into any other plug in the house, excluding a bathroom GFI outlet because they're not compatible with the Quick 220. With your 110 power cords, you want to make sure that you've got a good quality 12 gauge cord, and also look at the end of your cord and make sure that you've got a proper ground on both the cords. Now with the Quick 220, we want to make sure that the breaker is on in the on position, and then we want to plug in our 110 cords. You should hear a click. Then the second cord, when we get that plugged in, you should get an orange light. So now that we've got the Quick 220 box properly hooked up, now we're ready to plug the Viper in. So I'm going to take the 220 cord, and I'm first of all going to plug this adapter into it, like that. And that goes into the Quick 220, like this. And then we take the other end of the cord and we plug it into the Viper, and now we have power. If the orange light is not on in the Quick 220, what you want to do is take one of the plugs and move it to different plugins until you do get the orange light. In a commercial job where you're using the Quick 220, you want to plug into a 110 wall receptacle on each side of the panel. So we would come to the panel, we'd find a plug-in that is on one side of the panel, and then we would find a plug-in that is on the other side of the panel. If you lose power to your machine, you want to make sure that all of your cords are properly connected. They're twist lock cords, so make sure that those are put in properly. As well, you want to make sure that your Quick 220, the breaker on it, is on. And lastly, you want to make sure that at your main panel, that the breaker you're running off of is on.